Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, Bob Bush.
How do you do, guys? I'm Bob Bush, and I'm the Irish-looking Jew. How you doing? Actually, I'm a Jewish leprechaun. We're kind of like the Irish leprechaun, only much, much cheaper. And us Jews, we want to be called thrifty Americans from now on. That's what we want to be called, thrifty Americans. I'm considering converting to Christianity, and you might be wondering why. I love Jesus, I really do, but something that has tempted me even more is bacon. Bacon is not kosher to us Jews, so I'm doing it all for the bacon. My wife, who is Christian and wants me to become Christian too, has been putting bacon in my mouth as I sleep. Moving my mouth up and down, forcing me to eat bacon. Then going like this and whispering in my ear, "You love bacon, you love Jesus." If you die from heart disease from bacon, you will die, go to heaven, and eat bacon with Jesus in heaven. So, I have considered converting just for that. I think the Christian religion needs a new slogan, and that slogan is, "Come for the bacon, stay for the Savior." You know who also likes bacon? Chris Christie. Have you guys ever seen Chris Christie? Chris Christie has pants that come up to here. Okay, his belt is right here. His zipper, when he pulls up his zipper, it's like, zzzz. It's like, what is the deal with those high pants? What is it? Old men, certain old men get high pants. It's an affliction that affects certain old men. And the pants get higher and higher as they get older. When you hear about some men that die of natural causes, the pants reach their nipples, and that's it. You get strangled in your own pants. It's true. It's true. You get strangled in your own pants. How many people out here love dogs? Yeah. Anybody love dogs? I love dogs, too. This is a picture of my dog. Okay? His name is, my owner is not gay, but he really loves fluffy dogs. Dogs love to snap at a hot dog. They go up to hot dog, snap. Snap at a hot dog, snap at this, snap at that. All I gotta say is, to make a long story short, I am never going around the house naked again. I know this Italian dude named Tony, and he goes, "I don't want to adopt a male dog. It's gay. Kissing a male dog is gay." I'm like, "Dude, why can't you adopt a male dog?" "I gotta have a female dog, not a male dog. Why? Why? I'm gonna kiss it and squeeze it." I'm like, "Dude, how far is this relationship gonna go? How far is this gonna go with your dog?" Now, have you guys ever seen commercials for drugs? Have you guys seen these commercials? And they show the commercial and they don't tell you what the drug does. So I saw this commercial for drugs, and there are these women running around all happy, yay! So I'm thinking, I want to take that drug too. And I asked my doctor and he prescribed it to me. Well, I got to tell you, I'm very happy with the drug. My vagina has never been moister. Have you guys noticed that, all right, that's all now. Have you guys noticed that depression drugs actually have a warning on them that says may cause suicide? Is that a good idea? Is that good? And by the way, certain household items should have a warning on them as well. For instance, beer. Beer should have a warning on it that says may cause you to fight a cop. That's the warning there. May cause you to have sex with a stranger. Tequila should have a warning. May have sex with three strangers. May have a fight with five cops. What about LSD? LSD has a warning. The LSD warning is may cause you to pop a pimple until you realize that pimple is your nipple. Now, what is the side effect to marijuana. Does anybody know? Coming to a comedy club on a Wednesday night. Now, by the way, the final side effect is bacon has a side effect too. It causes an Irish leprechaun to do an open mic at Zany's. You guys are awesome. Enjoy the bacon.